Good morning, and I'd like to welcome everyone to this, the 15th meeting of the Standards, Procedure and Public Appointments Committee in 2024. I have received an apology this morning from the member Annie Wells, but welcome other members to this meeting. Our first agenda item is a decision on taking business in private. The committee has to do to confirm that they're happy to take item 6. This is consideration of a complaint the committee has received in relation to the cross-party group on commercial sexual exploitation. Are members happy to take that in private?
Yes.
Excellent. I'm grateful. Our second agenda item is to consider an application for recognition from the proposed cross-party group on brain tumours. And I would like to welcome Beatrice Wishart, MSP, to the meeting. Beatrice is the proposed convener of the proposed group on brain tumours, and she is joining us online this morning. Good morning, Beatrice. Can I hand over to you for an introduction of the intentions behind this CPG, please?
Thank you, convener. And firstly, can I apologise for not being with you in person? I was attending the opening ceremony of a spaceport in Shetland yesterday, and logistics wouldn't allow me to get to you in person. And I suspect it'll be the only spaceport that I'm opening that I will be at in my lifetime. Can I firstly say that I have a personal interest in brain tumours, as my daughter lives with a brain tumour. And it's often only because people are affected in terms of family or friends who have a brain tumour that you become interested in a bit more about the illness. As the application suggests, we have a cross-party support for this, and I think everybody who has put their name to this application will find that will have a similar personal interest in it. The point about having a cross-party group, although we have one on cancers, is actually to be a bit more specific about brain tumours. We know that around 1,000 people in Scotland are diagnosed with a brain tumour or cancer each year, and that a huge number of those people are people under 40. And it appears as though there has not been much progress made in the last 2 or 3 decades. And by having a cross-party group, the intention is to focus a bit more on what we can do to try and bring clinical side and patients together and make some progress on advancing better outcomes.
Thank you very much, Beatrice. I'm just jealous that you made a spaceport opening. I think that's quite unique, but let's hope not the last time. Do the members of the committee have any questions of the proposed convener? Can I come to you, Oliver?
Yes. Obviously, the member referenced in her opening remarks the cross-party group on cancer and the potential for some crossover, and I was just interested whether the member thinks there would be a chance in the future for those groups, if this one does get approved, to work together, from time to time.
Absolutely, I do. I think it would be very important that we do, given that there is a crossover, although they're slightly distinct, but I do think that there will be opportunities for crossover.
Thank you, Oliver. I mean, one of the concerns that this committee has expressed, and indeed members have expressed, is the number of CPGs. I know there's very significant cross-party support in the documentation, but when I look at the non-MSP members of the group, I note that you have individuals and also the brain tumour research who are also going to act as the secretariat. Is there significant interest, do you think, from other non-MSP members, non-MSPs who may wish to become members of this group if it is afforded accreditation?
Yes, I do think that is the, and I think the APPG for brain tumours demonstrates that from the House of Commons. So I think that would be, I think there would be more interest, yes. And I think also I could reference the event that we had earlier this year, the people who came to the parliamentary event, and we heard from the one of the patrons of brain tumour research, Theo Burrell, and she spoke very passionately about the situation for brain tumours. So I think there is an interest out there. And I absolutely take, convener, your point about there being a lot of cross-party groups. I understand that.
I'm very grateful for that. Can I thank you for attending committee this morning, and no problem with it being remote. The committee will now consider whether or not to approve the application for recognition at agenda item 3, and the clerks will inform you of the committee's decision thereafter. But can I thank you for attending this morning, Beatrice?
Thank you, convener, and thank you, committee.
So agenda item 3 is indeed to consider whether or not we are minded to recognise the proposed cross-party group on brain tumours. Are there any comments before I formally put the question? No? Then are we happy to accord recognition to the proposed cross-party group on brain tumours? Yes. Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. Agenda item 4 is an application to approve a name change. A request has been received from the CPG on drug and alcohol misuse to change its name to the CPG on substance use. Clarification has been sought from the conveners of the CPG about whether any changes to the purpose of the group are also proposed to reflect the change of name. And in our papers, you will see in the annex that there is a new purpose that's set out. The change being proposed is to move from just drug and alcohol misuse to substances use in Scotland. There are a number of options open to us. We can agree this if we feel that the application that was originally made for the drug and alcohol misuse CPG is encompassed in the new. If we feel that there seems to be a broadening or changing in that, we could ask the convener to attend to explain it. Or alternatively, we could suggest that a new formal application for a different CPG be made. And I'm happy to take thoughts and ideas. Alistair, if I come to you first.
Thank you, convener. I don't see any reason not to accede to the request for a change to name. I think that might be simpler than the other options.
Fine. Are we in agreement with that then? Excellent. Then if we're in agreement, the committee is happy to approve the name change. And then item 5, annual report. So as is required by standing orders, each committee publishes an annual report, and the committee have before it its draft report from 2023. Through to 2024. The report deals with membership changes, meetings, the work that we've done by way of legislation, inquiries and case studies, evidence that we've taken from the Minister, code of conduct, complaints that have been received, post-legislative scrutiny, and the Parliamentary Corporation supported bodies, the commissioners who've been before us along with other groups. Details of the petition that is with us is contained in it, along with the equal opportunities and, indeed, as we've just done in this session, the cross-party groups, which fill a substantial amount of certainly the clerk's time, as well as ours on occasions. Are there any comments that any of the members would like to make about the draft annual report? No? There's a tiny amendment in paragraph 26, which I understand will be taken ahead before it's actually published, and then it will be formatted in unusual annual report style. So I'll be happy for that to be finalised and published. Yes. Excellent. I'm grateful. I will now move this meeting into private.